Dear students, we have been discussing the prospice karma. So, in our previous class, we had discussed how Lakshmi took her meal before boarding the train, and from her conversation with the coolie, we get an idea of the marital life of Sir Mohanlal. তার বৈবাহিক বা বিবাহিত জীবনের কিছুটা তথ্য আমরা পাই. হোয়াট ইজ ইট? দ্য রিলেশনশিপ, দ্য ম্যারাইটাল রিলেশনশিপ অফ স্যার মোহনলাল ইজ নট নর্মাল, ইট ইজ ফার ফ্রম নর্মাল. হি ডজ নট ট্রিট হিজ ওয়াইফ অ্যাজ ইজ ইকুয়াল, রাদার হি লুকস আপন হার অ্যাজ আ মেড সার্ভেন্ট. And he never treats her in a proper manner. For example, Sir Mohanlal is traveling first class, but his wife is traveling interclass. Why? Because Mohanlal is a barrister, a high official, and he meets many Englishmen and important people. They speak in English. But Sir Mohanlal's wife Lakshmi, a native Indian woman, cannot speak in English. That's why Sir Mohanlal does not allow his wife to travel with him. His wife travels interclass and he travels first class. Moreover, in the house, Sir Mohanlal lives on the ground floor of the house. And Lakshmi lives in the upper story of the house. That means the husband and the wife do not share the same story of the building. Sometimes Sir Mohanlal visited his wife at night, but it did not normalize the relationship between Sir Mohanlal and his wife. After taking her meal, Lakshmi thanked gods and then she waited for the train. We are starting from that point. The train steamed in. Lakshmi steamed in. That means in those days, the engine moved on steam. It was a steam engine. Lakshmi found herself facing an almost empty inter-class zanana compartment next to the guard's van. As the coolie had said, the inter-class zanana compartment was almost empty. It was next to the guard's van at the tail end of the train. The tail end, that means the fag end, ekdam sheshe. It was at the fag end of the train, it was next to the guard's van. The question may be asked, Where was the zanana compartment? The zanana compartment was situated at the tail end of the train next to the guard's van. The rest of the train was packed. Except the ladies' compartment, all the other compartments were overcrowded. Packed means overcrowded. She heaved her squat, bulky frame through the door and found a seat by the window. To heave means to force oneself, jor kara. She forced herself through the frame of the door. Why did she have to force herself? She had to force herself because she was short and thick. She was short, she was thick, she was bulky. Bulky means fat. That's why it was not very easy for her to enter through the door. So she heaved her squat, bulky frame through the door, and fortunately she found a window seat. She produced a two-anna bit from a knot in her sari and dismissed the coolie. She paid the coolie. How much did she pay the coolie? She paid the coolie 2 annas, and she dismissed the coolie. That means she asked him to go away. Because the coolie had placed her luggage inside the train compartment and she had now no use of the coolie. She then opened her betel case and made herself two betel leaves. Lakshmi or Lady Lal, a native Indian woman, was very much addicted to betel leaves. Tini pan khete khubi bhalobashen, tini pane ashokto. So she made herself two betel leaves charged with a red and white paste, minced betel nuts and cardamoms. Minced means cut into pieces. These things were used for the preparation of the betel leaves. She used a paste which was red and white in color. She also used betel nuts. Betel nuts, that means nuts that can be found inside the betel fruits. That means shupuri. The betel nuts and cardamoms, elach. So these were used to make the betel leaves. Then she thrust into her mouth. These she thrust into her mouth till her cheeks bulged on both sides. Bulged, that means increased in size. When she forced the two betel leaves inside her mouth, naturally there was little space for anything. Naturally, when two betel leaves were forced into the mouth, her cheeks increased in size, bulged. Then she rested her chin on her hands, chin, thutni. She rested it, that means she kept it on her hand. She kept her chin on her hands and sat gazing idly at the jostling crowd on the platform. To gaze means to stare, to look fixedly at something. She gazed idly at what? At the crowd on the platform. There were many people on the platform. There was a crowd and the crowd was jostling. That means pushing and pulling one another. It is a very common scene found in an Indian platform. People always jostle with one another. They push and pull to enter the train because all the platforms are heavily crowded and the trains are also packed to capacity. The arrival of the train did not disturb Sir Mohanlal Sangfroid. Meanwhile, Sir Mohanlal was taking rest in the first-class waiting room. When the train arrived, it did not disturb his Sangfroid. Sangfroid means the ability to keep calm in a difficult situation. Kothin paristhitito shanto thakar khomota, that is Sangfroid. Sir Mohanlal Sangfroid was not disturbed because Sir Mohanlal was a first-class passenger and the first-class would be almost without passengers, almost empty. Very few people had the money to travel first-class. So Sir Mohanlal was not in a hurry. His mental calm was not disturbed by the arrival of the train. When other people were pushing, pulling, shouting, running, Sir Mohanlal was at ease. He was feeling comfortable. He continued to sip his scotch and ordered the bearer to tell him when he had moved the luggage to a first-class compartment. Scotch whiskey. Sir Mohanlal was enjoying his whiskey and he ordered the bearer to keep his luggage, to carry his luggage and keep it in the first-class compartment and only then inform him. After his luggage has been kept in the first-class compartment, only then Sir Mohanlal would walk slowly towards the first-class train compartment. He was not in a hurry because he was a first-class passenger.